It's my pleasure to introduce my observatory, Croatian Sustainable Tourism Observatory. And I would like you to see how nice name we have. We are Krosto, a part of INSTO. So we are very proud of our name. Let me first introduce shortly our institute. So Institute for Tourism in Croatia is a public research institute, a pretty old one. We are founded in 1959. We are doing research in economy of tourism. We are doing tourism satellite accounts as economic impact of tourism. We are doing surveys on visitor behavior. And we are, of course, trying for Croatia to have a sustainable tourism development. And from 2016, we are a pretty young tourism observatory. In 2016, we joined the INSTO network. What I would like to share with you today is a pretty concrete experiences we have in the first year of a measurement process in Croatia, in measurement of sustainable tourism indicators. And following our experiences, I would like maybe to provoke some discussion on methodological issues and maybe to some fine-tuning of indicators. So first of all, Krosto, as a Croatian Sustainable Tourism Observatory, as Croatia is a Mediterranean country, Krosto is really consists of these seven counties, the seaside part of Croatia. It is according to this NUTS-2 region, consisting of seven NUTS-3 regions or seven counties. Which is similar to Greece. In this part of Croatia is about 90% of overall tourism activity, and the majority of that activity is between June and September. The main tourism product in Croatia, in this part of Croatia, is of course sun and sea. This part is attractive by its natural attractiveness, but also has several UNESCO sites and national and nature parks. Similar to Greece, we have a lot of islands, not so many as Greece, but a lot. 50 of them are inhabited, so we do have similar maybe issues and challenges as Greece, but also as other Mediterranean countries. Regarding the indicators, I don't know if you see anything of this. We tried to overlap UNWTO mandatory issues and European Tourism Indicator System Indicator, so ETIS indicators. And we started with 14 indicators. Similar to our colleague from Mexico, we were thinking maybe better to start with a smaller set of indicators and then extend that set of indicators in the future. I didn't mention when I said that we are observatory for this Adriatic part of Croatia, which consists of seven counties. The similar with this set of indicators, we would like in the future to each country to have its own observatory and to incorporate or consist of local destinations. But as for now, we started as observatory for this seven counties, and in the first year of the process, we managed to calculate 12 indicators out of 14 for each of seven counties and for the whole area, of course. Two indicators is percentage of residents who are satisfied with tourism and percentage of tourism enterprises with labels. We didn't mention to have data for that. I think there is no need to go through the indicators. They are, as I said, UNWTO mandatory indicators overlapped with ETIS indicators. And the main data sources for all these indicators were Central Bureau of Statistics, then Croatian Agency for Environment and Nature Protection, Energy Institute, Ministry of Construction and Physical Planning, and several surveys that our institute is conducting. One of them is longitudinal survey on attitudes and expenditure of tourists in Croatia. We are conducted it every 3 to 4 years, and this is one of the major data source for some of the indicators. I didn't mention that institute is the leading part of our observatory, but we have a local stakeholder group consisting of more or less national stakeholders, Ministry of Tourism, Central Bureau of Statistics at one of the major data sources, then Croatian Agency for Environment, etc., etc. And we, our plan for next year is to involve local stakeholders from national tourism boards of these 7 counties. So our estimation of our system of tourism statistics is that it is pretty good one, and it's enabling us a sufficient disaggregation and extraction of indicators for each county level. So, for example, Central Bureau of Statistics has some data for national level, but they were able to extract this data for the level of counties. But what we, during this process of measurement, what we came up to, and I think these are maybe the major points that we would like to discuss with all of you, are these challenges in the measurement process. We divided challenges on national and international level, and on national level is availability of needed up-to-date information. For example, we do have number of tourists in commercial accommodation, but we don't have a precise number of tourists in non-commercial accommodation or same-day visitors. And some of our indicators suggested by UNWTO and by ETIS are number of tourists. Which one? All tourists, one-day visitors, or just overnight visitors? So we think that it will be good to precisely define indicator, what does it mean? Some of the indicators needed to be slightly modified in the case of Croatian territory. I will show you some examples a little bit later. And of course, our surveys are highly dependent on financial resources. Examples of why some of the indicators need some corrections. For example, it is ETIS and UNWTO indicator, percentage of sewage from destination treated to at least secondary level. Our Central Bureau of Statistics has this data, and we collected the data on the county level, and it was pretty easy. But it is the Adriatic coast and a lot of islands. A lot of households are not on the sewage system. So what does it mean if we have 70% of sewage from destination treated to at least secondary level? It's very good. But just 20% of households are on sewage system. So we had to correct this indicator by the amount of households on sewage system. Regarding the other indicator, for example, direct tourism employment as percentage of total employment, we do have data, as probably all other countries, or at least those in Europe that has to have by Eurostat. We have employment in national classification of in accommodation and food service. But we all know that this is just a part of tourism employment. What about all these employed in sport activities, giving sport activities? What about this in cultural institutions, which are not employed only by tourism, but partly their employment is connected to tourism, and so and so. And finally, besides these challenges on national level, some of these we already mentioned in this morning discussion is that we would really like to be comparable. So now we have these indicators, these 12 indicators for our 7 counties. And what now? Are they good in sustainability or not? Are some other destinations better, or we are the best? We would like to be comparable with at least maybe Mediterranean countries. So as Dirk mentioned, there is need maybe to have these regional observatories. Not only regional because of similar challenges, but we also think that these observatories are highly dependent on tourism product. We have here colleagues from South Tyrol, and their tourism product is completely different than our sun and sea tourism product. Then we also have this nautical tourism or yachting tourism. Probably Greece has the same problems with a lot of yachts and these small and big cruise ships, etc., etc. So there is need to be comparable. Maybe to somehow have a set of indicators regarding the tourism products. And the final one is that when we wanted to disseminate this data to our stakeholders, we haven't done that yet, because I was thinking maybe at this meeting I would learn something on dissemination. So how to show all these 12 indicators in an easy way? Because stakeholders on local level and those on national level want some easy information, not 12 indicators, more or less complicated. So it would be nice maybe to discuss how to aggregate those indicators, or maybe to evaluate some compound indicator. And of course, it would be nice to have some baseline values or intervals just to know what is the best practice. Thank you very much, and I hope that we will have some nice discussion on this. Thank you.